Yeah, let's go ahead and get the praise report. We're all want to hear this.
So, as many of you know, we have been going through it with our daughter, Ashlyn. And it did seem very, very grim at first. We didn't even know that she had stage 4 cancer with mets to the lungs. What took her to the hospital was she had pneumonia, and that's how we found it. So truly, that saved her life with it. When we got her transferred, March 7th, early morning, it was about 4:45, we got transferred. We're still in the hospital. She is responding so, so, so well. We can see her lungs now, both sides. Even the right side, that was absolutely, completely just diminished. We can see everything. Everything is shrinking. Now, she has a little bit of opaqueness in her lungs still, but she's breathing. She got her NG tube in yesterday, which means we're working on getting rid of her TPN and her lipids. And that's one step closer to coming home. And they told us as long as she keeps responding well, and she's just, this little girl has not lost her faith. And you know what? If that little girl, starting at 3 years old, to right now when she just turned 4 last Thursday, if she cannot be shaken, why would I be as her mom? That little girl, as much as we have gone through, and I'm with her day in and day out, and I just see God working with her and just see the amazingness in his strength, because honestly, I am very weak and I would have broke by now. This girl is just going through it and she's just taking it head on with everything, and it's not even phasing her. So we did trim her hair the other day because it is coming out and we're going to shave her head, and she wants me to paint little flowers on her. So we're going to do that, but she's already up with, she has been up, and we have to keep a hold of her because she tries to run, and we can't let her do that with all of her lines in that end because we don't want her to rip out her pick line or anything. But this girl is just a walking testimony, and she is just, everything is just full force with her, and she's not giving up, and she has no sight of giving up. That little girl has the heart of a lion at 4 years old. And I tell you what, I see God in everything with her. Each and every day, I just see prayers answered. I just see this little girl just wanting to get better. And she's still listening to her worship music. She's still saying her prayers. Her and I were praying the other night, and I laid my head on hers, and I was hugging her while I was praying, and she started crying. And I said, "What's wrong, honey?" And she flat out told me, she's like, "I saw Jesus." And I was like, "What are you talking about?" And she was just crying happy tears, and she said that he said that she was going to be okay.
My blessed God, is that all you can do? Stand up, shout, glory, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I want to see Jesus in this house today, hallelujah. He's here. I want to see him. I want to see the cloud just fill this place today. Hallelujah. Let's go to God in prayer. Holy God, we come before you. God, we praise you for this praise report. Oh, God. God, you were so faithful. You were so good. Oh, God, that even Jesus would show himself to a 4-year-old child and deliver the message that you're going to be all right. Dear God, I know that today we as adults, we sit here many times with clouded minds and crowded minds with thoughts and fears and worries. But God, to know today that you're in control of everything. God, we just pray, Father, for every name that was called out here today. Oh, God, every hand that was raised today, Father. Oh, God, you know the need. And I just pray right now, God, do a mighty work in lives today, Father. God, I pray that there'll be transformation in our lives today. Dear God, that Jesus Christ will be high and lifted up. Oh, God, that we will worship you today. Oh, God, with everything that's within inside of us today, oh, God. Oh, God, for you deserve the glory today, oh, God. We love you. We praise you, God. And God, we would be remiss if we did not pray for Israel right now. Dear God, we pray for strength and guidance, protection. God, we pray for peace for Israel and Jerusalem today. Dear God, we just pray, Father, that your will be accomplished this day, God, in our lives. God, we might worship you and serve you. Oh, God, have your way today in this place and in our lives. In the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, we ask it. Amen and amen. Remain standing. Let's sing.
Shout to the Lord, all the earth, let us sing.
shout to the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. Glory. Amen.
I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. 'Cause all my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire. In darkest night, you are close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness of God. 'Cause all my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so the goodness of God. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I've surrendered now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I'm surrendered now. I give you everything. It's running after me. 'Cause all my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. 'Cause all my life you have been faithful,
all my life you have been so good.
With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. 'Cause all my life
and testify this morning that God has been good to you and faithful all your life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can you just testify this morning? Hallelujah. Did he pick you up at your lowest point in life and stand you up on the solid rock foundation of Jesus Christ? Did he wake you up this morning in your right mind today? Hallelujah. 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 Testify this morning. Hallelujah.
I love your voice. You have led me through the fire. In darkest night, you were close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend. And I am living in the goodness of God. 'Cause all my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. 'Cause all my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I will sing of the goodness of God. I will sing of the goodness of God. I will sing of the goodness of God.
Hallelujah.
It's running after me. Your goodness is running after. It's running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after. It's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I'm surrendered now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me.
'Cause all my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God.
All my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. I will sing of the goodness of God. I will sing of the goodness of God.
Hallelujah. Glory to the Lamb of God. Hallelujah.
Come on, lift our hands, amen. Let's honor him this morning, amen. Oh, let's just offer ourselves. The Bible says a living sacrifice, amen, this morning. May our praise and our worship, Lord, be acceptable in your sight this morning, Lord. Oh, what beautiful worship. Oh, I love it, church. To worship with the people of God and exalt his holy and mighty name in his house this morning, Lord. We glorify, we magnify you today. Oh, come on with the voice, with your voices this morning. Just let him know you love him this morning. For a moment, we bless you. We love you this morning. Oh, hallelujah. Praise your name, Lord. I love you, Lord, this morning. Hallelujah. Oh, isn't that song beautiful, an anthem of the church now? Lay my head down, he's faithful. When I wake up, he's faithful. We can't accuse him of being unfaithful, because that's a faithful God we serve, amen. Oh, my soul doth magnify him this morning, amen. Amen, hallelujah. Well, that's good to me. Come on, give him praise, amen. May we never, and I know in our physical bodies that sometimes we get weary, but may we never get weary in our soul and spirit magnifying the Lord. This is something we've got to look forward to throughout all eternity. We change the words of that song, maybe in eternity, we can sing, instead of saying all my life, we say, all through eternity, Lord, you have been faithful. You cannot be accused of being unfaithful. His word is true. His word endures forever. I'm just enjoying if you're saying, Brother Bateman don't look like he knows what he wants to do. I really don't. I'm just feel his presence. Amen. My soul doth magnify the Lord this morning. I'm just overjoyed in his presence this morning. Amen. We love you, Lord, this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, God, this morning. Praise your name, Lord. Well, we're going to continue on. We're going to worship now when given. I do want to say, I want to appreciate ahead of time. I know they mentioned it in our announcements for those pregnancy center banquet is coming up at the end of this month. We appreciate those that are supporting. We have a few more tables we'd like to be sponsored. So the Lord laid that on your heart. We're not going to beat it over the head. But you know, that's a ministry here that we partnered with the last few years, and I'm very much a part of it. Sister Annie Norman here, we serve seeing babies. When I get an email saying that there's a woman, they send us out an email saying pray, because there's a woman that's come in and she's abortion minded. And people begin to pray, and then she comes in and she changes her mind and gives birth to that baby. That lets me know we're on the right track, amen. And we're here this coming, I think it's the 25th. We're going to be here on a Thursday night, and we're going to have we're hosting their banquet, but we're partnering with them. And so we just, it's a fundraiser. We want to continue to be a part of what God is doing there, amen, and lives are being changed. So thank you in advance, amen. We're going to lift a tithe and the offering this morning. I want to give just a tithe is 10% of what you bring into your household. You say, well, brother, I don't understand how that works, but I can promise you this. I'm terrible at math. Did you know that? I'm terrible at math. So this is really, this makes sense to me, because God said, if you'll give me 10%, I'll take the 90 that he lets you have and me have. He said, you'll do more with that 90 than you ever could do with the 100%. That makes no sense in math. But God put it this way. He said, try me. Prove me. And I will open the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing upon you that you cannot contain. It is not a promise that you're going to be wealthy, but it is a promise that God is faithful to take care of his people. Amen. That's the best retirement plan known to mankind. We also have this day, we give up, they take the offering. We'll give our missions offering. We have two types of missions giving here. We give to home missions. That's pregnancy centers included in that, other endeavors that we do in the community, and also in the region. Those are specifically to help reach unsaved people. And then we do world missions. We sponsor ministry to Israel, and we also sponsor fountains to rivers in the Dominican Republic and others. So the monies that are given go to wonderful causes to promote the kingdom of God. And also other giving that we do is we help out in benevolence. That's the poor and the needy in the community, situations that arise. So I can promise you this. If you'll give, the Lord will bless you for what you're giving. I don't have cute stories. I don't have anecdotes. I don't have these amazing stories of to try to encourage you or to wow you to give more money than what you give. Just pray about it and ask the Lord to help you. But I can promise you this, you cannot outgive the Lord. Would you stand? Let's get ready to bring our tithe and offerings into the Lord's storehouse. The Bible said God loves a cheerful giver. Amen. Now, I know people looked at me a little funny then and said, well, wait a minute, God's going to, if I give 10% of my income, God's going to take the 90% and I'll be able to do more with that than I can do with 100, because that's something that is done in the supernatural. Amen. Come on and say amen. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you this morning. We thank you for the wonderful hand of God, the presence of God that we feel in this place. Lord, it's not never our desire, nor is it our purpose is to weary the people of God. But Lord, through giving, we experience the liberty of giving abundantly and cheerfully and intentionally to the work of the Lord. And God, we just pray, Lord, as I get ready to present my tithe and my offerings and my missions given to the work of the Lord, God, and knowing that your hand is upon it, bless this, your people, the gift and the giver, Lord, and we'll give you praise. And everybody said, amen. Come on, get out of your seats to the front. There's some buckets and baskets in the back. Back at this time, God bless you as you give.
Amen. Thank you for the way that you gave in the offerings today. We appreciate you obeying God. You know, there's a lot going on right now. You don't have to watch the news very long and know there's a lot going on right now. But, you know, I've just got a feeling it's all going to work out. Because I know who's in control. Amen.
Well, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Well, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Oh, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Be all right. Be all right. Be all right.
God sent Moses to lead all his people out. Pharaoh's heart was hard and thought he'd give them the route. So we chased him all down to the Red Sea shore. He thought he wouldn't have to worry about Moses anymore. But Moses stretched his rod out over the sea, and the Lord answered Moses with a little gentle breeze. I can see Moses now with a smile on his face, telling all the people with his gentle grace. Well, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Well, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Oh, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Be all right. Be all right. Be all right.
A little boy named David went out to fight the giant.
Everyone laughed to such a funny little sight. A little shepherd boy armed only with a sling. Beside mighty Goliath seemed such a puny little thing. But David said, you come to me with spear and a sword. I come to you in the name of the Lord. He put in a stone and he gave it a fling. And when he left his hand, oh, he began to sing. I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Well, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Oh, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Be all right, be all right, be all right. Now for the greatest story of them all. Jesus was dying and hell had a ball. All the demons were rejoicing. They thought they had won the war. But soon they would not be laughing anymore. On that first Easter morning when the sun woke up the earth, the caverns of the deep opened up as to give birth to a resurrected Savior with healing in his wings. Now the host of children rise and sing. I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Well, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Oh, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Be all right, be all right, be all right. Be all right, be all right, be all right.
Somebody give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Amen. Amen. Thank y'all. Would y'all stand tonight, this morning? Amen. Psalm 6. Woo. I didn't even sing that, Brother Kenny, but I'm wore out. Amen. Oh, amen. That just ties so beautifully in with my sermon this morning. We've been blessed already today, hadn't we? God's just preparing us for the word of the Lord, amen, and touching us. And but, you know, really, even if I didn't preach this morning, I am, but even if I didn't, we could go and we could say already, it's been good to be here. I don't know about you, I have felt the Lord in this place, God confirming to us he's alive and well. One noted philosopher from a day gone by, he said, God is dead. And I thought, what a foolish statement. The Bible says that the fool has said in his heart, there is no God. I challenge anybody, whoever they are, what their belief systems are, ever how they were raised, they'd have been in this service this morning up to this point, they'd have felt God in this house. They may not have understood it, but they would have known there is a God, amen. The psalmist said in 16:8, I have set the Lord always before me. Because he is at my right hand, I shall not be moved. And I'm going to preach for a few minutes in just a moment. But we got to... There's power in our words. Now, I ain't trying to be a word faith preacher. I love what David is declaring here. I have set the Lord always before me. Because he is at my right hand, I shall not be moved. Verse 9. Therefore, David said, my heart is glad. This word glory here talks about our inward being. He said, my glory rejoiceth. My flesh or my body also shall rest in hope. We're going to leave out of here this morning declaring God's word, his promises. Promises of God are yes and amen. Father, we thank you this morning for a tremendous outpouring of your spirit. You have delighted us. We've rejoiced in the God of our salvation. We've lifted up songs of Zion and magnified your name. Lord, we felt your presence, Lord, as you fill this place. Lord, I know what you live in us. But there's just something special about the people of God in corporate worship. With one mind and one heart. So, Lord, now take what's already been done. Prepare our hearts to receive this word this morning. Don't let us leave here the same way. To the most seasoned saint or the youngest Christian in here, God, change every one of us. Speak to our hearts. Lord, if there's someone here today that's lost, we're praying salvation. Lord, that eyes would be open to that glorious gospel. God, if there's a healing that needs to take place physically, emotionally, spiritually, Lord God, we'll pray that it'll take place, Lord God. There's someone here burdened and about to give up. Lord, we're going to pray, God, that you are going to just re-energize them, body, soul, and spirit. Help us to lift up our heads because our redemption draweth nigh. Bless the reading and the preaching of the word. And the people of God said, amen. Amen. God bless you as you're seated in the house of the Lord today. I want to preach for a little while this morning on, I titled it, Recognizing the Presence of God. If you'll go back to verse 8 there, I'm going to take my time and I want us to realize the truths that are so prevalent in this word. Now, I didn't bring the other translations that I was going to read other than just the King James out of the text of my personal Bible, but I think the King James is pretty clear of what is going on here this morning. David has said, in the title of this particular psalm in some of the Bibles and the headings is the joy or pathway of our lives. Amen. So how many of you know that God gives us everything that we need to live this life right here in the Word of God? You know, I thank God. I'm going to go on record, on permanent record on the internet and on tape and CD, whatever it is, that I thank God for every medicine. I thank God for every therapist. I thank God for every hospital. I thank God for every doctor. And I thank God for every mental health counselor and everybody that that helps to make our lives better, whether it's a physical, an emotional, or a spiritual need. But amen, I still want to just take a moment and say, God, I thank you, Lord, that you're Lord over my life, and Lord, that you order my steps, God. And then when I lay my head down at night and when I wake up in the morning, I can rejoice as there's a God that is always before me. Amen. Greater is he that is within me than he that is in this world. It does not matter what I'm going to face come Monday morning. If the Lord wakes me up, I'm going to get up tomorrow morning, I can promise you. And even before I go to bed tonight, and I'm going to say like the psalmist David said, the Lord is always before me. Somebody lift your hand and thank God that you've got a God that never leaves you. He never forsakes you. Amen. And we cannot accuse him of being unfaithful. Amen. He said, I didn't say it. He said, I'll go with you always, even to the very end. Amen. David said, if I ascend to heaven, there he is. If I descend in the depths of the Hades, there he is. Amen. But I thank God today that the God I serve, amen, never sleeps nor slumbers. Amen. Whose eye is on the sparrow, and I know that he's watching over me. Somebody praise him in his house this morning. I want to preach for a little while on recognizing the presence of the Lord. And really, it's our duty this morning to remind ourselves and to declare with the words of our mouths, amen. You know, we could wake up and say, well, and let me just use different illustrations because I don't know where people are today. I don't know if you need a financial miracle. And I know I'm so careful as a preacher not to talk a lot about money because we have such a bad reputation on television, always talking and begging for money, all these money grubbing preachers. Look, get that out of your mind right now, what we're gonna talk about. I'm gonna talk to you about that God knows what your financial situation is. Because the God that we serve knows the number of hair on your head. The Bible says that he knows the thoughts that you have. He knows the words that you're going to speak even before you speak them. So I'm thinking that if he knows the hair on my head, the thoughts in my heart, the words before I'm going to speak, he knows the days that I'm going to live because they were numbered. He knew me before he formed me in my mother's womb. Help me now. So if he knows all of them things, don't you think, amen, that he knows what your financial needs are this morning? Well, then thank God. Be like David and said, the Lord is always before me. He took care of me yesterday. He's got me today. And no matter what happens tomorrow morning, amen, or what the next day brings, I've got a God that lives in my tomorrow that knows, amen, he knows how to feed the sparrow. Come on, somebody, and help me say amen in his house. The psalmist said, I've set the Lord always before me, and I'm going to trust him to be the champion that he's always been. Oh, Brother Kenny sang. I tell you what, brother, I don't know if I talk fast. I don't know if I can sing that fast. I thank God, David, he was a champion for David. He was the same God. Abraham needed a ram, and the ram was in the bush. Daniel needed a deliverer out of the lion's den. The three Hebrew boys needed a deliverer out of the fire. The children of Egypt needed a deliverer from the Egyptian army that was breathing down their neck. That same God who was their champion is our champion, amen. That same God that protected Daniel in the lion's den. That same God that fed the 5,000. Come on, somebody. That same God is the God who is my champion, and he is ever before me. Amen. I'm telling you right now, there was a guy on the radio, he used to say, I'm too anointed to be disappointed. He said, I'm too blessed to be stressed. Now, I'm going to tell you something. I do get disappointed, and I know we can't live there all the time. I do get bummed out. There are times, amen, where I guess I've been depressed and discouraged about things, but I'm just reminded, amen, that the same God that lifted me out, amen, the last time is my champion today that fights my battle. If God be for me, then who can be against me? Come on, somebody. My champion is with me, amen. He's never failed me. He's never forsaken me, amen. And he's given me that promise that I'm going with you. Come on and say amen. I want to challenge our way of thinking. I loved it. I was raised up. Young folks in here don't know it, but there was I've done it before. I'm going to do it again. I like to do it. Hee-haw was on TV for 30 years. One of my favorite songs was Gloom, Despair, and Agony on Me. Deep Dog Depression. I love doing that. Y'all probably tired of it. Excessive Misery. If it weren't for bad luck, I'd have no luck at all. Gloom, Despair, and Agony on Me. Come on here now. I've gone to church with a lot of folks that sing. I choose this morning to sing because he lives. I can face tomorrow. I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Come on, somebody. I want to sing Keep on the Firing Line. I want to sing the old songs of the hymn. I've been washed in the blood of the Lamb. There is power in the blood. Amen. Come on, somebody. Oh, hallelujah. God's always, my champion is with me. I don't have to fear. Listen, I understand that I saw all that on the news, that all that Iranian, whatever they were, drones and missiles coming in. And I see, you know, Israel knocking them down, and the United States helping them. United States better help Israel. Come on. Amen. Come on. I'm going to tell you, but let me tell you something. They call it the Iron Dome over there. That's a military. I don't understand all that high high-tech stuff, but they've got a weapon system that is almost impenetrable, if that's the right word. You can't hardly get through. They can knock those missiles that are coming in down. But there is one that looks down from heaven, that watches over Israel. Amen. He said, you're the apple of my eye. Amen. And there's coming a day when our champion is going to sit on the throne of his father. I'm about to preach here on his father David. Amen. He's going to rule in that city for all eternity. The Bible said we'll need no light in that city because Jesus Christ himself is the light. Amen. We'll be worshiping in that new Jerusalem for all eternity. Come on, lift your hands and bless the God. Our champion rules and he reigns. Somebody say amen. So we're to trust the Lord as our champion and our guard. This is the privilege of every saint. You know, I saw Donald Trump was down at the Chick-fil-A down in Georgia a couple of weeks ago, handing out milkshakes and chicken sandwiches. I wish I'd have been there. I'd love to have an old chicken sandwich with Mr. Trump. Oh, yes, come on here. And all y'all that voted for Joe Biden, shame on you. Come on, I'm on. We got a prayer line over here for y'all right after church. And I'm going to tell you something, amen. I've said it a lot from this pulpit, that these current events, we're going to stand. We're going to pray with Israel. Come on here. And I'm going to tell you right now, any time that any of our leaders start turning their back on the nation of Israel and the people of Israel, amen, just let me remind you of something. Our God is the champion of Israel. Yes, he is, amen. Hey, we better stand beside him. But if we forsake him, there is one, amen. That same God that was with David when he picked up the stone. That same God that was with Gideon, amen, with 300 people. That same God that was with Samson, the jawbone of a donkey, amen. That same champion, amen, stands in the gap between Israel and their destruction, amen. I'm telling you right now. And that same God said to this, upon my rock, this church, I'll build my church, amen, and the gates of hell cannot prevail. I don't know about you, but I'm glad to be a part of something that the devil can't tear down. Come on, somebody, and praise him in his house. Come on here and help me this morning. David said, always, yesterday, today, tomorrow, he's at my right hand. Listen, this is where church folks, saved people, not just church folks. Let me be careful here. Because I'm going to tell you something right now. Joining the church don't make you a Christian. Getting baptized in that water up there don't make you a Christian. What makes you a Christian is you repent, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, confess your sins, turn away from your ways, amen. Put your faith and trust in God. Come on, somebody, and say, that's what makes you a Christian. I'm not talking to church folks. I'm talking to Christians right now. Let me tell you something. David said, the Lord is going to be ever before me. Now, you ready? I want you to say it with me, this last part. I shall not be moved. Come on, y'all didn't come on here. I'm going to do you like Sergeant Carter did. I can't hear you. Finding out who my old folks are in here. Come on. I shall not be moved. That's a bold declaration, amen. Why? It's not within myself or my own physical abilities or anything that I've done, amen. But it's because I put my faith in the Word of God. I put my faith in a resurrected Savior. I put my faith, amen, on him that died upon the cross, amen. I put my faith in him that said, if you kill me in 3 days, I'll get up, amen. I put my faith in him that soon coming King, amen. I put my faith in him, amen, that said, no weapon formed against you prosper. I put my faith in him. He said that you'll tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy. That's who I put my faith in. So now I can boldly declare, I shall not be moved. Come on and lift your hand and give the God of heaven praise in his house. Jesus said, always, no matter who I am with. See, we're too vague sometimes in this kind of preaching. We get a little too vague. Oh, God knows your circumstances. Oh, yeah, no, no. Listen, hear me. Hear me. Y'all in better shape. Last week, that man preached at 1 o'clock. Your condition, your situation is not vague. It is specific to you. It is what you are facing, whether it is a terrible financial crisis, whether it's an emotional, mental breakdown, whether it's a spiritual battle that you're facing, a medical diagnosis, it's specific to you. And David is saying this, no matter what it is, God is with you right in the middle of it, amen. And God is telling the church, it's time, amen, to not just being so vague about everything and to say, God, if you're always with me, you know where I'm at, you know what I have need of, amen. So I'm going to call on you, God, right now. And when the devil comes against us, when that crowd, amen, comes against us, when the society like we're living in now is crumbling right before our very eyes, when we see those that would attack the church and those that will attack for what we believe and what we stand for and mock and ridicule, we don't do it smugly, we don't do it arrogantly, but we say the Lord is with me and I shall not be moved. Come on, somebody, and say amen. I just want to encourage you, amen, and be like David. When I call you and say, hey, how you doing? I know you're going through it, brother. I want to hear you call me back and say, Brother Bateman, I don't know how I'm going to make it, but I'm not going to be moved. See, some folks can only come to church and shout when everything is going good. I'm not talking about none of y'all. It's just folks listening online. Some folks can only, when everything's going, money in the bank, health is good, mentally they're all good, amen. But David said, God, the Lord, I've set the Lord before my eyes always. And I'm going to declare, we get a hold of this today. I believe you, many of you know it. I'm just trying to reinforce it this morning, that you're going to make it. There ain't no, the devil cannot pluck you out of the hands of God. Those that are around you that don't understand you or don't understand why you believe the way you believe cannot persuade you. Paul said, I am persuaded that neither life nor death. Good gracious. Principalities or powers, those that lie on you, those that tell the truth, none of that is able to separate me from the love of God. I am engraven in his hands. Amen. Dear God, he knows my name. Hallelujah. He knows my uprising and my downsetting. Amen. Oh, one of Deuteronomy said, we're blessed when we go in and we're blessed when we go out. We're blessed when we wake up. We're blessed when we lay down. Come on, somebody. Amen. The devil slipped by and told some of you that you're not going to make it. Amen. But tell that liar, amen, that I shall not be moved. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Gonna do it. I was somewhere the other day. The man was preaching. He was preaching hard. He pulled me. I ain't got no money. I'd do it. And they done took the offering up. He took the money out, took $2 or $3 off. He said, that's such good preaching. I'm gonna give myself an offering. I ain't preaching that good, son. And I'm gonna tell you, I'm gonna magnify the God of that. Sometimes we look around and look at our conditions and situations and wonder, where's the God of heaven? David said it this way, I've set him before me, always. Oh, God, I don't have time to get into all this, but it talks about the right hand. See, in the Bible, say I'm left-handed, predominantly left-handed, and the Bible speaks of the right hand as being the one of power, the the son of my right hand is the firstborn and the chosen. Jesus, when he was finished on the cross and he ascended up into heaven, he sat down on the right hand of God. So it's not just a coincidence that David's saying, I'm going to set him on my right hand, representing when I need power. Come on here. I know a God that has all power. Jesus said, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. I want to serve that one that delegated that power. He said, I'll give you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy. Amen. You know, that one, my elder brother, amen, my Lord and my Savior. Look, on my left hand, you know, I got my wife, my children, and over here I got my church folks and my church family. Over here I got mom and dad. Over here I got this and that. But wait a minute, over here on the right hand, let me introduce you to somebody. Oh, he goes by a lot of different names. They called him the son of Joseph, the son of Mary. They called him the son of God. They called him the son of the Most High. Let me introduce you to a few more names. We call him King of Kings and Lord of Lords. We call him Lord of Glory. We call him high and lifted up. We call him holy, 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 Lord God Almighty. I got this crowd over here and I appreciate them. My family, my church family, all of these. But on my right hand, let me tell you, there's one over here that's my champion. He's never lost, amen. He's never been defeated, amen. And I'm going to hitch my ride all the way to glory with the Lord Jesus Christ. That's a good place to thank God this morning. Woo! No matter what my state, wealth, poverty, thick or thin, battles, wars, peace or chaos, hunger or cold, friend or foe, David said, Lord, you with me. And I'm going to preach this to myself. Lord, the next time I got to, you know, one preacher said it this way, next time I get ready to go through something, just remember, either you're coming out of a storm, you're getting ready to go into one, or you're right in the middle of one. That just discouraged me. I thought, Lord, ain't we going to get no place where that we, yeah, well, then I thought about Psalm 23, where I can just lay down. God gives us some times of peace and rest, amen. Lay our head down in those green pastures. Let me tell you something. It don't matter who you with. Listen, y'all know what I'm talking about. Back in the day, y'all ain't none of y'all, but you had your posse, your boys, your peeps. I ain't got no help. As long as you rolling with them, you had it covered. I had a friend of mine, he visited here a little bit before he died and gave his heart to the Lord, raised up over there on Doodle Hill, Mike and them, some of them boys, Jack Todd. He'd rather fight than eat. So, you know, every time we went anywhere, I had Jack over here. Well, he's probably on my right hand. I didn't have Jesus then. Anytime anybody wanted to, you know, I think y'all figured this out. I got a lot of mouth. The Lord's really helped me though. I talk a little junk. I always had Jack. He didn't wait on nobody. He just, I mean, I was talking, next thing you know, he done flew, hit somebody in the jaw and knocked him out. But it don't matter. See, I don't have a crew like that now. Well, I got Kenny back here, and man, we got security. Don't you mess with me up here. Got Brother Toole in the crow's nest up there. Y'all think he's just up there looking at the camera. He got my front. Kenny got my back. And I got two or three others out here. Y'all can't mess with me. That's why I talk like I do with Big Boy Mike. But there's one. There's one that's watching over us. You know, we ain't going nowhere till the good Lord says we go. Come on now. God wants us to see, and I'm going to try to close here best I can. God wants to see, I got you. God wants you to be like David and said, Lord, you're at my right. I'm not going to be moved. Now, let's go to verse 9. I'll try to wrap it up. I ain't got none of this. I'm preach part two of this tonight. I'm not. Therefore, my heart is glad. Come on, people.
We ought to be the happiest bunch on the face of the earth. Bible said, don't fear him that can kill you. Fear him that can kill you and cast your soul into hell. No, I'll never forget my next door neighbor lived across the street from me in Williamson years ago when I was a young teenager in the mid to late 70s. And she was talking to my mom, and she was a good Baptist woman, preached over here at Emmanuel Baptist School here years and years ago. And she was talking to my mom and they about her doctor's appointment. And she said the doctor kind of threatened her about her health and everything. And she said, don't threaten me. I ain't scared. God, you talking about a promotion. We got to get that mindset that, like Job, well, God, whether you slay me or let me live, I belong to you and I'm going to serve you. I'm yours, God, in the good times. Sound like an old country and western song. In the good times. And in the bad, I hate country music, by the way. In the bad times. I done offended half of you right there. But in the good times, in a good old gospel choir, in the good times and in the bad times, y'all ain't going to help me here. I am going to trust you, God. Woo! Come on here. We've got to learn, amen, no matter what our circumstances are, no matter what our state, our wealth, our poverty, thick or thin, battles and wars, who we with, what group we with. Because sometimes people will wear you out. Come on and say amen. I got a couple things I'm going to share. I'm not going to do all of this. Sister Ellen, if you'll come out, we got to pray after this. I want you, when you get ready to come pray, I just want you to come stand around this altar. If you have a need, we'll pray with you and anoint you. But I just want you to come and I want you to come and declare the words of the Lord. Let's let God confirm his word today. God, I'm not going to be moved. I don't think anybody, hopefully nobody here is almost on that point of I'm going to give up and backslide and I'm weary in you, God. But if you are, today is your day to get refueled. David said, my heart is glad. I'm happy. And I don't care if it, one preacher said, hair lips the devil. I don't even know what that means. I'm going to rejoice in the God of my salvation. I'm saved my name. The Bible said, rejoice not that the devils are subject unto you. Rejoice that your names are written down in the Lamb's book of life. I'm going to heaven. I'm on my way to glory land. I'll not turn back. I did want to share this, and I'm going to try to close. Sister Ellen usually gives me about 5 minutes before she starts playing. You're right, I'm just picking. That's your key that I'm closing. In the internet, let me say this, and I promise I'll close. In social media today, statistics tell us that 95% of us are online. 95% of people in America are online in some capacity. So the internet and social media, TikTok, Instagram, YouTube, whatever these other ones are, has become so influential. And how people think. It shapes and it influences them. This is a modern phenomenon that we didn't have, my generation didn't have, where there are young people and old folks that are on the internet, social media, and they're called influencers. They're beauty influencers, physical fitness influencers. There is something on. There is some kind of influencer for nearly every genre. And I was researching this and I found a guy. He's an illegal immigrant from Venezuela. And he has become an internet influencer of some renown in America because he's telling all the other illegal immigrants how to beat the system. how to get into people's houses that are abandoned or empty, and get in there and become a squatter and take it over and then start charging rent. And he's on the internet with piles of cash, just grinning and laughing. And I thought to myself, they need to arrest him. And they did. But when they arrested him, he said, I really didn't mean any of that. That was just a character I was acting. Movie stars influence our generation. Pop stars. I read an article the other day that Taylor Swift, who's probably the most famous singer on the face of the earth, had endorsed Joe Biden for president. That's all I needed to know. I don't listen to her music, no way. But I can tell you what she has done because of her wealth and her fame and her influence. She will influence young voting age women. She will influence that generation of younger children. Come on here. So what are you saying, brother? If you let this world influence you and your belief on what who God is and what God is, we need the men of God and the women of God and Sunday school teachers. We need to be teaching to our children. In case you hadn't looked around, there's an epidemic of sexual immorality that is going unchecked and unabated. There is a battle in our nation for the minds of this young generation. Y'all hear me now, if you're young here. God has ordained, come on, a man and a woman. And if they get married, that's the only partner they're supposed to have. Y'all, come on, help me here. Let somebody on the internet hear an amen. But we need men and women. We need parents that will influence this next generation about who God is and what God is. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. David put it this way. When you start thinking about God always being on your right hand, if you start thinking about God always set before you, your champion, your joy, your strength, your deliverer, your comforter, that will influence the way you live your life. I want you to stand. I'm closing. I got so much more. If we really believe the Lord was coming back, it would influence the way we live our lives. Amen? I just wanted to make sure this was on. So all heads are bowed, eyes are closed. We're going to pray. I watched a video the other day, an influencer. I assume it was a girl, sounded like a girl. She made up a new category. She said, I'm trigender. This stuff's happening every day. People are making it up as they go along. There is an assault against our educational system. The State Department just hired a DEI chief, a diversity, equity, and inclusion chief. While all this garbage is a Marxist indoctrination to undermine God's design and God's order. Come on and say amen. I could go on and give you illustration after illustration after illustration. But we're going to be like David.
No matter what they throw at us, no matter what they say about us, no matter what they do, we shall not be moved. Like a tree planted by the waters, we shall not be moved. My anchor holds. I am determined. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. No one is able to pluck me out of the hands of God. I'm going on. I'm going through, no matter what it might cost me. Someone here today, if you're lost, we're gonna give an altar call. I want everybody that can and would come. And if you can't come, don't leave just yet. Pray just a moment or two at your seat if you don't come to the altar. But I want everybody in just a moment to come. But if you're lost this morning, you know, I was very naive. I was raised up in the church. I gave my heart briefly as a teenage boy, young teenage boy. It didn't last no time. But I came back to the Lord as a very young man, and I was very naive. I thought when I got saved that all my troubles were over. I'm sorry, I did. I was naive. And when trouble came and trials and tribulations and temptations came, my foundation was a little shaky. My knowledge of my salvation was a little shaky. But over the years, I came to find out many are the afflictions of the righteous. Anybody know the rest of that? But the Lord delivered him out of them all. God is with you, church. I want to ask everybody that can and would you come and declare the words of the Lord this morning? Come on, let's fill these altars for just a few minutes. It's just 12:15. We got time to pray. Come on, people of God, fill these altars. Fill these altars. Just take a moment. You can kneel, stand, worship together. Come on, let's rejoice this morning in the God of our salvation. Stretch your hands. Help me pray for my brother here. Lord, he needs a touch in his body this morning. God, we're just going to stand.